Let's start with question number 25. Now, this question belongs to section oscillation and waves. Let's see what the question says. A rod of mass M and length L, 2L, is suspended at its middle by a wire. It exhibits torsional oscillations if two masses each, M, are attached at a distance L by 2 from its center on both sides. It reduces the oscillation frequency by 20%. The value of ratio small m by capital M is close to. Now for this question, it is very most important thing is, first of all, we'll draw the diagram. Now let's assume that this is a roof and it's suspended. The suspension is for this rod of length L, right? This and this being L. The mass of the rod is capital M. So initially there was some torsional oscillations, and due to that oscillation it was having some angular velocity. So I need to relate that angular velocity with moment of inertia first. So what would be the relation? As you are aware, omega is proportional to under root of moment of inertia, right? Now with this case, after some time I hang two small m masses on the either side, right? And they were at some tangent distance, and this distance from the center was L by 2 on this side as well. So definitely initially there will be separate omega, and after adding these masses we will get separate omega. So just note it down, omega 1 upon omega 2 will be I2 by I1. Now we need the value of moment of inertia in the cases here. Let's find I1 first. In order to find I1, whenever a rod is pivoted or the axis of rotation is at the center of mass, the moment of inertia would be half m L square, and here in this case the length is twice of L, so I am putting this. You will get 1 by 12 m into 4 L square, thus it is m L square by 3. We have I1 with us. Now in the second case, when you add masses, that is small m, then there will be the moment of inertia of rod itself plus the moment of inertia of the masses. So I'll write capital M L square by 3 plus moment of inertia of one mass would be M into L by 2 whole square. This is the case of discrete mass, and we have one another mass also like this. On solving, you will get capital M L square by 3 plus this is M L square by 2. So you have the value of I2 and I1 as well. Consider this as equation 1 and this as equation 2. On putting the values for omega 1 by omega 2, you will get m L square by 3 plus small m L square by 2 whole divided by m L square by 3. And it is also given in the question that after adding the masses, the rotational frequency reduces by 20%. That means initially if it was 1, the new angular frequency would be 0.8. On solving this, you will get 1 plus 3 small m by 2 capital M, right? Now, just shift this under root on this side, you will get 1 by 0.64 equals to 1 plus 3 small m by 2 capital M. Now you will get 1 by 0.64 minus 1 is equals to 3 small m by 2 capital M. So this is 0.36 by 0.64 is equals to 3m by 2 capital M. What we require in the question is important, that is we have been asked small m by capital M, right? So we just have to do this 2 by 3 into 0.36 by 0.64 is equals to small m by capital M. Cancelling this, this would be 9 by 16, this is 1, this is 8, this is 1, this is 3. So finally you will get this as 3 by 8. Let's see which is the best suited option here. Among the given four options, so answer to this question would be option 3. Right? Now let's move on to our next question, that is question number 26. Now in this question, there are two plane mirrors. This question belongs to section optics and basically it is geometrical optics. So two plane mirrors are inclined to each other such that a ray of light is incident on the first mirror M1. While falling on M1, it was parallel to M2. And finally, after reflection from N1, it was parallel to M1. So let's see what is the angle between the two mirrors. So let's first draw the diagram in this case. Let's consider this as M2 and this as M1, right? This is mirror 2 and this being mirror 1. Now, our incident light was falling like this. So, at the time of falling on this surface, it was parallel to M2. After reflection from M1, it felt like this and went parallel to M1. So, as you can trace the path of light ray, let's take this as angle theta, right? Now, if this is theta angle, so certainly this angle shall also be theta, right? And this angle shall also be theta angle as the corresponding angles, right? Now, whatever angle the incident light makes with the plane mirror before or at the point of incidence will be the same angle made by the reflected ray with the mirror. And if this is theta and this is theta, similar will be the case here. If this is theta angle, this will also be theta angle. So if I mark these three points as P, Q and R, you can see that triangle PQR is an equilateral triangle where all the three angles are same. In that case, theta would be 60 degree. So the angle between the mirrors would be simply, yes, it is 60 degree. Answer to this question would be option 4, right? Let's move ahead to question number 27. Now this question belongs to the section electromagnetism of chapter electrostatics. In here, the charge is distributed within a sphere of radius r, which have charge density as this, where capital A and small a are constants. So if the total charge on that sphere is capital Q, we have to find radius r of same. So let's start with the solution. In order to understand this question properly, first of all, we will be needing a diagram. So here I have made the diagram for you of a sphere. The radius of this would be capital R. Now, I have taken a small hollow sphere of radius R inside it, and the thickness of this would be dr. I'll start from this segment that it is having a very small charge dq, and then I will integrate this hollow sphere into this complete sphere. So this dq would be simply equal to charge density into the small volume of this sphere. What would be the volume of this hollow sphere? That is surface area into the thickness. What is the surface area of this? Is 4 pi r square into the thickness, which is dr. So from here, if I take on dq as rho into 4 pi r square into dr, and what is the value of rho, which is given to us? A by r square, e power minus 2r by a into 4 pi r square into dr. As you can see, this r square and this r square will be cancelled. So you are left with 4 pi a e minus 2r by a into dr. Now we need to integrate this from 0 to q. And this integration shall be from 0 to r, right? On solving, you will get that 4 pi a is constant, it will come out. You are left with integral of e minus 2 r by a into dr from 0 to r. And this integration will give you 4 pi a e minus 2 r by a divided by minus 2 by a. Now, the limit of this would be from 0 to capital R. Now, so 4 pi a, this is divided by minus 2 by a, this is a constant, it will come out. Now, I will use this as, I have put the upper limit and the lower limit as well. Now, solving this one, you will get 4 pi a small a minus 2. This has e minus 2r by a minus 1. this is equals to Q. Now this and this will be cancelled. So I will have 2. So just shift everything here. You will get Q upon 2 pi capital A small a negative, that would be equal to E minus 2R by A minus 1. Let's rearrange things here. So what you will get is E minus 2R by A would be equal to 1 minus Q by 2 pi capital A small a. Now just take the natural log on both sides, you will get minus 2R by A would be equal to log base E 1 minus Q by 2 pi capital A small a. So from here R would be equal to A by 2, here log base E 1 by 1 minus Q upon 2 pi capital A small a. So let's see which is the best suited option here. So among this 4 options, option 1 would be our best option. Hope this was clear to you. Let's move ahead to our next question.